both go our separate ways and head home.
That's enough. Right there, what he just said about the eyes, that's enough for me to move across the fucking country. This is what we gonna do tonight. Since it's raining, it's cloudy, it's just nasty outside. Tonight, we just gonna chill together. We gonna relax together. We just gonna have a good, nice, chill night tonight. All right, can we do that? You know, we can do that. All right, cool. Sounds like a plan. Sounds like a bet. I got my cuddle buddy. I got my snacks on deck. If you don't have a cuddle buddy, then I can. I got you. You know, I can be a cuddle buddy, right? If you don't have any snacks, I can be your snack. I'm not gonna act like I just didn't say that, because I did. But look, in all seriousness though, if you don't have a snack and or cuddle buddy, then you're fucked. Sup? No.
Do you like Kentucky Fried Chicken?
Yes.
Well, earlier this month, a man named Martin Bates bought a 3-piece meal from a KFC restaurant in New South Wales. And this is what he bit into. Yes, those are cute little baby flies.
You're watching Darkness Prevails,
the best place to share your creepy stories with the world. Because this world is a strange one.
Right.
Hey, don't get me wrong. I love KFC.
I'm so sorry for all of this noise that I just made, because I'm kind of like contradicting myself, because I know who you know, if you're watching this video and like the room that you're in, or like the building or whatever, like wherever you're watching this video right now, it's probably quiet and you probably just heard this. Oh shit. Nope. Every popcorn counts. But you probably just heard all that noise. I'm sorry. Because I hate that. I hate when I'm in a movie theater or somewhere quiet, especially a movie theater, and somebody is just making unnecessary noise. I hate that. Like, if you have a chip or a nacho, why are you eating that bitch slow? Don't eat it slow. Don't be like, just get it over with. 2 seconds. That's all you need. Why do you need 50 seconds to eat one tiny ass nacho?
Eat there at least once a year. But every time you eat fast food, you're putting blind trust in the employees and the people around you.
Right.
You're hoping the food will be cooked well, and that no one will try to end your life. Enjoy these allegedly true KFC scary stories. If you want to hear your story in a future video, I'm looking for scary experiences with people who used Lyft. If you've got a creepy experience from using Lyft, send it to me at darknessprevails.org/submit. Also, stay till the end for my favorite early comments from the previous episode.
Okay.
Now, I hope you're ready, because this is going to be finger-licking good.
You ready?
Number one.
Let's go.
KFC Creepers. Submitted by Letty98.
Letty?
I work at a KFC in Colorado. I've worked for the company for 3 years now, and I started at an older store and recently moved to a newer one. The older store I worked at was in a smaller town. Not quite small enough to say that the closest neighbors were very far away, but it didn't have any big businesses there. The closest Walmart was about 5 miles down the road, at the very edge of town. Besides that, Dairy Queen and Sonic, KFC was the only other franchise in town. The place was really out of the way. We always closed early as well, because we got maybe 6 customers from 8 to 9. We were, however, supposed to close at 10, so we still got a few cars from time to time, because none of the big bosses in the company knew we closed too early. That old store had a broken door, So people could still get inside if we didn't make sure to shut it all the way.
Oh no.
Giving it that little extra nudge. Most of the time, people were understanding about it. But there were a few that weren't that normal.
What you mean? Whoa, it sound like to me that you're letting motherfuckers in when you're not supposed to. Lock the doors and windows. If you can't, or if you're having trouble, use some fucking duct tape or something. Like, fuck. Do some I Am Legend shit. Like, have some like some metal shits to cover the shit. I don't know. Like, I feel like you're playing. Like, it just started. Like, come on, yo. We're not doing this tonight. We're supposed to be chilling. We're supposed to be good. We're supposed to be vibing, but... okay.
There was one group who came in when we only had the drive-thru still open. There were three men altogether, and they had been drinking. One of them apparently had trouble with his pants, because he literally had his junk hanging out.
Wow.
There were currently only three women still there. None of us prepared to defend ourselves, and one man, our fry cook. The cooks were usually gone sooner, because they didn't cook anything in the last hour and a half. We were open, but they still needed to clean their area. Now, the cook was in the back when they came in, as he was just finishing up. He noticed we were having trouble with these guys, so he stood next to my cousin who worked with us, taking the order, as I prepared it, to quickly get them out of here. We made sure the door was locked and closed it afterwards. And that was the quick end to the worst experience of my first year.
You sure it was closed?
The next year I still worked at the small store. This experience happened when I forgot to check the door, meaning it wasn't shut all the way and could still be opened. My manager told me this story the next day. Some guy came in tripping more than usual. With these types of people, it was common for us to make them meals that were weird. Like they would often try to order what was basically a Scooby-Doo sandwich. We'd get people stacking things as high as possible, adding so many things to their food that it made it inedible and crazy expensive. Well, on a certain night, a night that I didn't lock the door like I thought I did, it was 11 p.m., and the store should have been closed. But everyone was running behind with their duties to close up.
Yeah, okay. Okay. Running behind my ass. You running behind, bitch, I'm running forward. While you back there at negative 6 miles out, I'm there. Over there. 6 miles plus. Anybody that does math, that knows math, negative, you don't want to be negative 6 miles out. Because you're clocking up. You want to be positive 6 miles out. Just saying. Falling behind. Bitch, I'm always on my A-game. You best believe that. Even when you think I'm not, bitch, I am. Always. I'm always on my A-game. And always on my toes. Tiptoeing in my Jordans. But. Remix. Tiptoeing in my Adidas.
In walks this guy. Again, he was tripping hard. Instead of going up to the register, he just sat down in the lobby, not making any noise.
That's fucking weird.
My manager said she'd grab the pan grabber, just in case she needed to defend herself. Then she walked over to speak to the man. He didn't respond. Instead, he just stared at her. His hands were fumbling around behind his back under his shirt, as if he was wondering if he should pull something out from behind there.
You had pulled out your Adidas and start hauling. Because the whole time he's right there in the KFC, that's time that you can be running. But you wasting the time that you running. You still in there. I know damn well KFC doesn't, a place like that doesn't pay you enough to just be standing there when shit pop off. I know that for a fact.
or to leave it alone. Why was he acting that way? And what did he have back there? My manager didn't know, and she was starting to get worried. Suddenly, one of the ovens going through its cleaning cycle made a loud noise, so she took the chance to call Isaac, one of the cooks, who had been working really late that night, and asked him if he was almost done, which was her inconspicuous way of calling for help, without panicking this unpredictable fellow. Now the strange man, seeing that she wasn't alone in the store, and that Isaac was a bit bigger than him, he got up from his seat and walked outside of the building. Apparently, he hadn't driven a car, and being all the way out here, there's really nothing very close by, so he must have walked quite the distance to get there, and didn't order anything. That man was up to no good, and my manager knew it, and to this day, she believes she got through that mess by the skin of her teeth. It still gives me goosebumps to think what would have happened had that man gone through with whatever he had been planning. Now, this year I'm in a new store that just opened. This one's in the middle of a shopping center, so we get more people and stay open later. The store is in a big parking lot housing many businesses, and there are a few strange things that happen. A lot of sketchy people. But these sketchy people try to avoid being noticed, so if there are still cars in the parking lot, we're typically pretty safe. But, just recently, a lady was trying to get inside. One of our guys opened the door to see if she needed help, and told her, "Sorry, we're closed." But she forced her way inside anyway.
Well, bitch, I'm forcing my way out the back side of the exit. That's all I'm saying. Saying, why you forcing your way in? I'm forcing my way out. Alex, move. Get the fuck up off me. Move. You playing. You can't be taking chances on people, male or female, adult, teen, or a kid. Like, you don't know what their intentions are. Especially nowadays, because this world is dangerous. And it seems like it gets crazier and crazier every single day. But you don't know what you don't know. You just don't know anymore. Like, people's intentions are just crazy, man. You just can't take that chance. An old lady or man could seem innocent. You get close enough to the old person, he gonna cluck you up. Just saying.
I was in the back of the building, putting a bag in a trash can, the last thing I had to do for the night, when another guy pokes his head around the corner and says someone got inside. One more guy and my manager, the same manager from the previous story, and myself look up. It's 11:15 p.m. No one should be here. We all walk up to the counter, letting her know that she is outnumbered. The lady pulls out these long black gloves and begins to ask if anyone could give her a ride.
Nope.
Now, I may be a paranoid person, but I have no problem with giving a ride to someone in need. But this woman, I didn't know her, and something just felt awfully strange about her.
Well, there you go.
So we all apologized and said no.
Oh, right.
Then she walked out of the building, met up with a man in the middle of the parking lot, who had a shopping cart full of different things, but it was too dark to make out exactly what. Then she took her gloves off, pulled something out of her pocket, then put it in the shopping cart. Then they both walked away. There's only one question I have from that encounter.
Why didn't you
mind? What were they planning to do? Anyway, I only have one thing to say after all of this. Don't go to a place after hours trying to get business. People are trying to do their jobs and go home like you. And sometimes the people who do come too late, they're not there for food.
Yeah.
Number two, Taco Hell, submitted by Sydney.
I don't even like Taco Bell.
I worked at a Taco Bell KFC hybrid store, and I always knew something was weird about the place. You would always get chills down your spine. Even if you were standing next to those hot ovens, you would also get what felt like someone breathing on you at times.
Fuck that.
And things would go missing, only to be found in the weirdest, and I mean weirdest, places.
Yeah, alright. Yeah, okay. Things go missing? Yeah, okay. You gotta be crazy to be stealing my shit. Cause I'm breaking a. Oh, I'm. Man. I'm breaking everybody's ankles and wrist. If he steal my shit. Just saying. Something come up missing in his mind. Bitch, your whole life missing. Just saying. You gotta be crazy. This is my bag. It's like a man purse. But I wear it like as a, it's a backpack too. But like, I take it almost everywhere I go. Because everything that's in that bag, I need. Well, or eventually. But you gotta be crazy to be stealing my junk. You're not about to eat. Well, yeah. I was gonna say, you gotta be crazy to steal my Adidas, but bitch is already on my feet, so that's not gonna happen. And even if you attempt to do it, I'm already gonna be 6 miles out, while you still here, negative 6 miles out.
One night, when I was the closing manager, and it was about time to close, I'd gone outside, turned off the menu lights, and as I'm closing the back door behind me, someone whispers into the speaker box in the drive-thru. I knew there was no one there, and I was right. The cameras showed there were no cars or kids near the box. What was odd was that the box could only be activated if you pulled a car up to it.
Okay.
This freaked me out a little bit, but I quickly reminded myself that the box was old, and someone had even hit it with their cars a couple of days before, so maybe it was just going haywire.
Haywire.
I should also mention that there were only two people that night, my coworker Nick and myself, and I was the only one with a headset on. As I was doing my manager's tasks, I made Nick count the money tills in the office. Now, something to know is when he counts money, he always locks the office door behind him.
Makes sense.
I started gathering the trash and went to throw it out. As I was walking back, I saw a shadowy figure in the doorway where I had just walked out.
Yeah, okay.
I blinked and rubbed my eyes, and the figure was no longer there. I was exhausted after a long day's work, thought I was just seeing things. I walked back in, and as I did, I smelled the worst stench I'd ever smelled. It was like some rotting animal. I thought that maybe the trash, since Taco Bell meat and KFC chicken don't really mix well together under a hot sun in a metal dumpster. I get inside and lock the back door, and then I start cutting up the boxes. Now, where I was in the back room, the only way you can see out of the door is if you're on the left of the doorway looking out, and all you can really see is the prep food area. As I'm cutting the boxes, I got bored, and I went and grabbed my phone, which was by the drive-thru window. So I walk out and set a box on the prep table, grabbed my phone, and walked back. I was distracted for a few seconds picking some music to listen to, so I forgot to grab the box that I had set down, and went back to cutting boxes in the back. Maybe 5 minutes later, something hits me in the back hard.
What the hell?
It stings.
Why did I jump? It was very subtle, so I don't know if y'all saw that on the camera, but when he said something hit me in the back, I jumped a little bit. Like I felt that. Why did I? Yo, these horror stories are getting like ridiculous now. Like I'm starting to like picture myself in these situations. I gotta chill, man, because he said something hit him in the back, but I'm right here, and I jumped a little bit, very subtle, so I don't know if y'all saw that, but like, god damn. I got, yo, when I watch some of these Jones, I'm like zoned in. I gotta like find like a balance because I'm gonna end up having like nightmares, bitch. Like I can't. I'm gonna end up getting paranoid. Tell me why I thought I saw something. See, that's what I'm talking about.
Turn around, nearly yelling, "What the heck?" Only to see that it was the box I had forgotten on the counter. This really scared me. I turned toward the front, wanting to know who did that, and I saw the color red moving from the doorway back into the kitchen. I thought I saw Nick, since our normal work shirts were red. I ran after him, and I went to the office and tried opening it, but it was locked. I knocked and Nick opens the door. Then I demanded him to tell me why he threw that at me. He looked at me confused, and that's when I finally realized he was wearing the manager shirt that day. Manager shirts are black. I was still confused, so I decided to rewind the camera. What I saw made my heart sink. I saw the box lying completely motionless, sitting there. And then it just launched itself at me.
There it is. There it is. That is all you need to know. You didn't even have to take it that far. You didn't even have to check the cameras. You know? There's only two things you can probably tell me to let me know that you're serious. Like 100%. And that's dead ass. If you be like, yo, I'm dead ass about to quit from this job, or like I'm dead ass about to, you know, beat up my sister's bully, or on mommies, or on mothers, or you know something, one of those, cause you say one of those two things, dead ass or on mothers, and that's how I know you not playing, like no games, like you dead ass serious. So when Nick said in the video, you know, if he would have said I dead ass, I was in here this whole time, what are you talking about, I would have been like, you know what, I'm gonna go ahead and head home. What do you mean? You still have like 10 other things to do. Okay, well, I'm gonna let you do that. Fuck those 10 other things. I'm about to go home right now because I feel like there's something in here and I don't know what it is. So, and I'm not taking that chance. Okay. Oh, you said you're gonna fire me? Okay. All right, fuck it. I'm gonna stay here. Bow! Big ass box just hit you out of nowhere. See what I'm saying? But yeah, dead ass and all mothers. I said all mothers, all mommies. Two things to let me know that you're 100% serious.
There was no one there. We watched it over a couple of times, and every time we saw it, the more I became distressed. And then there was a loud bang. We ran out. And all the food containers and drawers, pretty much everything, was out and had been ransacked. We heard the bang again, and once more ran to where we heard it.
Why?
It was in the walk-in freezer. We're almost to the freezer when the door just swings open. I literally fall back onto my butt, nearly screaming. That door is extremely heavy. It's not a door that can be opened from air pressure alone. I was done with that night. I told Nick we needed to get out of there. I ran out with our things, and I managed to shut off the lights as we left. Once we were outside, I locked the door, but the moment it locked, the lobby doors began to shake as if some deranged person was trying to get out desperately. Then it stopped. I dropped onto my knees. I didn't know what to do. I had never experienced something like this. Then Nick screams. It startles me, and I look over at him. and he's looking through the windows by the doors. And I swear to God, there were two red orbs, like eyes, sitting there. I was not about to assume those were two red eyes, so I looked behind us, expecting to see brake lights or something. But no, it was dark, yet there were those red eyes in the window. The two of us ran like we were running in a marathon. After trying to comprehend what happened, we both go our separate ways and head home.
That's enough. Right there, what he just said about the eyes, that's enough for me to move across the fucking country. You don't... What? Okay, see, there it is. There it is. I'm starting to get emotional because I'm such involved with these stories that I feel like I'm actually there. I would have said, fuck Nick. I wouldn't even have said anything. I would have just left. At that point, all I cared about was myself. I mean this in the most nicest of ways. I mean no disrespect, but fuck you, Nick. Fuck you. Okay, that's kind of harsh. I would have said fuck this. As I'm hauling ass. You man, come on.
I texted the morning manager that I was sorry for the mess and that I would come in early to explain what happened and to help them fix it.
Come in, nothing.
Once home, I smudged myself, a cleansing to drive away negativity and purify yourself. The next morning, I went back and hesitated going back inside that building. I pulled myself together and walked in. The place was clean, as if nothing had happened. The morning manager was there. Let's call her Kay. I explained to her everything. She didn't believe me right away, so I asked if we could review the tapes. She eventually relented. We get to the point where the box launches itself at me, and the video goes black.
Of course it does.
And it stays black. I remember thinking, now she'll never believe me. Before Kay could utter a word, we heard the same bang, bang, banging coming from outside the manager's office again. Wow. The same sound I had heard the previous night. Wow. And when we walk out, we were met with the same sight. The place was ransacked again. Kay was horrified, and so was I. We both walked out of the building and waited for the rest of the crew. But after these experiences, Nick, Kay, and I all quit the next day. Anywhere else would be better than that KFC Taco Bell.
I would have quit right then and there.
Number 3.
Fuck a 2 weeks.
KFC Horror Story. Submitted by Jahoon.
I did not know how to say that name. I thought it was Juan. No racist.
I was 26 years old and hungry one day, so I decided to go to KFC to get one of their potato bowls. But when I got there, as I often do, I decided for something else and settled with chicken tenders. After ordering, I parked and began to open my meal.
We're family and everything. And I love you guys. Hopefully you love me. I just farted, but I don't know if y'all heard that. So, just saying. Because the reason I'm saying this is because a while ago, I seen a comment saying, like, did you just, I don't know if I did or not, but, I seen a comment saying, you farted, and I think the person said, like, that's disgusting, or something like that, like, he got mad, or something, or he or she, I don't know, got mad, because I farted, like, I'm a person, I'm a human being, I fart. You know, I mean, I could edit it out, but, you know, what, we family, that's all. If you think we not family, then sorry. Hey, this is Raw. So anything happens. You know, if you hear me fart, I will say, excuse me. Well, yeah, I'll try to remember to say excuse me. I'm going to say excuse me every time I fart, because there's going to be some times where you don't hear me fart, you know. But if I let out like a big one, if I have to lift up my leg, obviously I might edit it out, or I'm going to say excuse me. But yeah, I just want to let y'all know for future references, future videos, if you ever hear me fart, don't, you know. Everybody farts. Now, my fart, okay, this is, point being, we family, that's all. Hashtag, we family. Even though farting is disgusting, it's natural. I like farting, it's nice. Oh, wait. See, oh, here it is. Cause that. I'm sorry. I had a lot of beans today, with some bacon in there. And sorry if you're eating right now. I love you. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. Okay. I'm gonna try to contain my bios and my farts. Sorry. I know there's people out there eating right now, so sorry. You know, I know there's people out there that don't even like. Oh, this is such. I'm gonna get back to the video. I'm sorry. Much love.
Saw something completely disgusting. There was one tender and then one something else. Specifically, a crispy breaded fried chicken head.
What the fuck?
One of the eyes was black and partially breaded over. Okay. But you could still see it, almost like it was looking at you. It had a beak and everything. I had nearly taken a bite out of it when I saw it. God, that burnt chicken eye looking at me.
Ew.
I threw it out right away, and I vomited, because I couldn't stop thinking about what other chicken parts I may have eaten, and not the good stuff either. After seeing a face in your food looking back at you, it's kind of terrifying. Yeah. How does that get past quality control? How do the cooks fail to notice that they're cooking a raw chicken head instead of the typical meat? If I didn't know any better, it seemed like some jerk put it in there as a joke. But I was not amused by this. When I calmed down a little bit, I grabbed the head that I had thrown, put it back in a box, deciding that I might need it for evidence. But all I really ended up doing was showing the other guys at Fort Bragg. After that, everyone in my company stopped eating KFC. I know it sounds funny, but you'll probably change your mind after you nearly take a bite out of something's eye or face. Really makes you wonder what else they serve up to you sometimes.
Yeah, that'll do that to you.
Number four.
Yeah.
The KFC regular.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons.
Submitted by Sassy.
That's one of the reasons why I don't eat McDonald's. That's a different video.
The KFC in my hometown was my first job. I would work the last 4 or 5 hours of the day, so I helped clean up every night. We threw quite a bit away at night, and we, myself mostly, would add some free sides to orders in attempts to get rid of the food before it was trashed. We had some homeless guys come in sometimes, but one of them drove my boss to invest in a panic button under the register. Because some of the homeless folk were beginning to loiter, and we were told to stop giving out freebies. If we continued, we could lose our jobs. Most of them understood, but one guy came in constantly asking if I could get something for free, like he used to. He would show up at different times, sometimes not being seen for months. He was turned away by everyone, throwing a fit and cursing us out, And on some nights, he would follow us after our shifts were over.
Yari.
My manager, a tall but thin girl my age, would go to Walmart nearby after work, and she would always see him there. My close friend that started after I did left one day to go see her mother next door, only to see him following her step for step between the parking lots. In a special meeting, my boss told everyone to call the police if we ever saw him nearby, and around that same time she went out to confront the man who threatened all of us. He was saying that we were threatening his ability to survive, and that if we kept doing that, that he would just as well take our lives. After all of that, I never went outside the building alone, never left home unarmed,
right.
And I always kept my car locked and inside of my job throughout the shift. Part of me felt bad that I couldn't at least feed someone who needed it, but part of me felt something else. That is, actual fear for my life, for the first time. I'd never had someone threaten me before. To this day, we often think we see the man at the corner of other buildings, around the corner of our building, peeking out from behind cars in the parking lot. It's getting to the point that we're afraid to throw food out, considering who we might run into and what they might do to survive. I guess I finally understand why we throw food away at the end of the shift instead of doing something with it. Number 5. Mealtime. Submitted by Eric G.
I feel like this one's gonna be disgusting.
My family and I one day were coming back from the beach, and we were famished. It was pretty late out, already getting dark. After having an argument with my siblings, we all finally decided on KFC. We went inside the lobby. There were only two other people there. Again, it was pretty late, probably almost their closing time. We ordered our food, and then sat down. After I sat down, I realized there was sand all over me, so I went to the bathroom to wash my hands up. I thought I was the only one in there. I turned the water on and began to work my business, when I suddenly heard a toilet seat violently close, as if someone wanted to be heard. I was suddenly startled and looking behind me at the stalls, save for the water running in the sink. It was silent once more. Feeling a bit suspicious, I looked down below the stalls to see if there are any feet.
Feeling a little suspicious, I hurried up and washed my fucking hands and get the fuck out of there. Who, like, legit washes their hands for, like, 30 seconds to a minute? Like, that's ridiculous. That's, like, that's, come on, that's, like, OD. Like, me, I wash my hands, maybe. I don't count the seconds. If you count the seconds that you wash your hands, that's OD like a motherfucker. But, I mean, I wash my hands. I wanna. Probably like 10 seconds? It's not like a quick tick 10 seconds. It's not like a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No. It's like a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, it's like that, you know. But if you're washing your hands for like 30 seconds and you counting like 1 Mississippi, 2, like, come on. What the fuck are you doing? What do you... You must be dirty as hell. That's all I gotta say about it. Like, either that or you just... You're one of those, like... OD. You're a clean freak or something. And I mean that in the most nicest of ways. I mean no disrespect when I say that, but... Yeah, man. Because I see... Like, when I go into, like, restaurants... And, like, you know, other places... And it says, sometimes they'll have, like, the time, you know, to wash your hands and stuff like that. And sometimes it says employees, you know, employees must wash their hands before going back to work. Obviously, Like, that's kind of nasty if you're not washing your hands after you use the bathroom. One of my biggest pet peeves, right, if you're out in public, I understand if you're the type of person that doesn't wash their hands after they use the bathroom, but at least use some hand sanitizer or something. Use something to, like, clean something. But if you're the type of person, and this is what really grinds my gears, shouts out to Family Guy, is the fact that if we're out in public, and I'm using, like, a public restroom, and you know I'm in the same bathroom as you, and you just got finished washing using the bathroom, and you just walked the fuck out as if you just didn't see me. Like, that's disgusting. Like, at least fake like you washing your hands or something. Don't just walk the fuck out like you just didn't see me. I know you saw me. That's disgusting. Come on. Or at least wait until after I'm finished washing my hands and I walk out and then you walk up right behind me. Even then, I know you didn't wash your hands. I know you saw me. There's been times, probably more than I can count, where I've been in public restrooms and I know either people have peed or have taken a shit and walking the fuck out. Like, that's disgusting. That's nasty, man. You're in public. Come on, yo. Come on. Especially if I'm, like, with my friends or family, and the person that I see that didn't wash their hands, they're out shopping or whatever, or they're at a restaurant. Oh, my God, if they're at a restaurant, I'd be like, watch out for that motherfucker. He didn't wash his hands. That dirty motherfucker didn't wash his fucking hands. That is so nasty. That is so nasty. Come on, yo. You're in public. If you ever experienced that, let me know that in the comment section below. Because, yeah, hashtag I experienced that before. Or just, like, hashtag I experienced. You didn't have to. Just let me know if you experienced that, because that's nasty. Because if you don't wash your hands out in public, I know for a fact, 100%, you don't wash your hands in the house. Because you're in the privacy of your own home. You're in the comfort of your own home. You don't care what people think about you in your house. You don't care what people think about you outside in public. That's disgusting. And that's why more often than not, when I'm in public and I have to use the bathroom, I would use my shirt to grab, like, door handle or something. Like, come on, you don't know what they got. Germs spread. Alright, I'm getting off topic. I'm sorry.
But I didn't see anything. I seemed to be as alone as I thought I was. I shrugged and finished up washing my hands. Then I left the bathroom and sat down. But something was nagging at me. And I found myself staring at the bathroom off and on, wanting to see if anyone else who came out after entering had a weird expression on their face. But no one else went in. I had been the only one. Now, here's where it gets really weird. All of a sudden, during the middle of our meal, a man walks out of the supposedly empty bathroom, and he's a mess, pants and shirt torn all over.
Damn.
My mouth was wide open, looking at the man. There was someone in there, and he had been trying to hide from me. I shook my head, thinking that maybe I had missed seeing someone go in, even though I'd been staring at that bathroom door. Or I thought maybe someone was hiding because they were feeling sick and didn't want to be embarrassed or spotted. But those theories were all thrown out the window. Because the man sat down across the way from me and stared back at me. Then he smiled. Then he winked at me. He knew what I was thinking. I turned back to my food and finished up quickly. I wanted to leave this place and never come back. As we finished our food, we got up and made our way to the door. And that's when I noticed the man had stopped looking at me, and instead was staring at his phone. A smartphone that didn't really match his appearance. The door was on the other side of the man across the lobby, and as I walked past him to get to the door, I turned and looked down at him. He was still looking at his phone. I glanced at the screen, and my eyes widened.
He took a picture.
It was me at the sink, water running.
Fucking.
It was me in the bathroom, being startled by the sound of the toilet seat, yet seeing no one in the bathroom with me. Yet, it was the angle that scared me the most. He wasn't filming me from a stall. He was filming from above me.
Oh my god.
He was hiding in the tiles on the ceiling.
What the fuck?
I hurried my friends out of the building, and we never went back near that KFC.
Okay.
The place is 3 hours away from where I live, and I will never go back there.
Damn. That'll do that to you.
Number 6. KFC Horror, submitted by Adriana M.
What the hell was he doing in a ceiling? Just chilling?
Where's he going? This happened a year ago when I was 17. I live in a fairly small town. Everyone knows everyone here. It's not a rare occurrence to bump into one of your friends at the grocery store. Due to the town being so small, there's only one KFC in it. I used to stop there every day after school to pick up some food, and I'd usually bring my best friend with me. We'd stop there to eat, work on some homework, talk about boys, you know, just the average stuff. But there were also times where my best friend, Kay, couldn't join me. Now, on this particular day, Kay couldn't join me because she had to go straight home to deal with family things. I was pondering the idea of just going home as well. But my stomach was growling, and I convinced myself otherwise. So, without Kay, I drove to KFC. The place was abnormally empty that day. There were probably only two other people there, and that's it. I walked in, and the smell of bleach instantly burned my nostrils.
Damn.
I shrugged this off and thought that maybe I walked in right when they were cleaning. I noticed there were only two workers there, too. A cook and some man running the register. The man looked to be around 40 or 50 years old. I couldn't really tell for sure. His beard was scraggly and gray. He didn't come off as the nicest person, but who was I to judge? I placed my order. But as I told him what I wanted to eat, he was eyeing me intensely, like I was some kind of puzzle. And he would win $1 million if he solved it.
Oh no.
I shifted nervously on my feet until my food was ready. Then I took it to the furthest table I could find. I'm not antisocial at all. In fact, I'm very extroverted. So for me to feel nervous like that, it was very strange for me. I tried to finish my food as much and as quickly as I could. But I felt nauseous. I felt like I wanted to go home.
Hurry the hell up.
I left the KFC with a lump in my throat. Even after exiting the building, it felt like there were eyes on me, eyes glued to me, watching my every step. I power walked until I was at my car, and while I jumbled with the keys in my hand, I looked behind me, and that's when I saw him. The cashier that had been creepily eyeballing me was now walking towards me.
Damn.
Making wide, fast strides.
Damn.
He was only a few meters away, and his eyes never blinked or left mine. I froze up. My feet felt like cement blocks. I couldn't move. When he reached me, he tightly grabbed a hold of my arm.
What the fuck?
I remember fear washing over me. I couldn't even think. I was like some sort of ragdoll instead of a person. He yanked at me, pulling me back to the KFC. He practically dragged me into the back door, where we were secluded from the only other worker, a spot that didn't seem to have any cameras. My heart was pounding in my chest, and every inhale burned like a hot coal being...
You clucked, I want to say that you clucked up when you noticed him eyeballing you. Like a piece of candy. First of all, that's disrespectful. That's disrespectful as hell. I mean, but I'm not going to lie because I do that shit. I do it too. Low-key, I think every guy does. I think everybody, person, male or female, doesn't. But it's the way you go about doing it. You know? Don't be a creep about it. But, like, I think that's where you clucked up was when you noticed him eyeballing you in a very creepy way. And, but you still shrugged it off. You know, you still shrugged it off. Right. So, that's where it was, you know. If this was me, you know, somebody, if I was in your situation, I would have grabbed that food. I would have made it to go. Just saying. Just saying.
Pressed against my chest and ribs, I finally spoke. "What do you want?" I cried. He slowly took a finger to his mouth as if to shush me, before shoving me hard against the wall.
Oh.
He pinned me there, then tried to kiss me.
Oh my god.
"This is what you wanted, isn't it?"
Oh my god.
He said in between heavy breathing. What in the world gave him that idea?
Wait a minute. Bro, he's doing this all in one night? What? That's crazy. I thought it was like a build up to it. Like one day, you know, he'll be looking at her in a creepy way. The other day, he'll try to talk to her. The other day, you know, the next day, he'll try to make a move. No, the next day, he'll try, like the next, you know, next day will just be something different that he's doing creepy wise. I didn't realize that he's doing all this shit in one night. God damn.
Finally, my mind shot back to life, and I realized if I didn't try to escape now, then it would just get worse. I lifted my knee, shoving it as hard as I could into his groin. He stumbled back, bent over, and groaned. I took this as my chance to run, and that I did.
Excuse me.
I ran to my car and pulled out of the lot as fast as I could. Now, I was too embarrassed to call the cops. I didn't tell anyone, actually. Part of me feels guilty, would you believe it? For leading him on somehow, even though I had not given him any signals of the sort. Just be aware of who you're surrounded by, and pay attention to the red flashing lights when they first appear.
Exactly. But that's me. I'm a very flirtatious person.
Number 7. Working at KFC. Submitted by Albino Kitty.
I'm a very flirtatious person. But I don't mean to be. That's just who I am. But I think I get it mixed up, or I don't know. I think I combine my flirtatious with my friendly, being very friendly. Because I've been told by a number of people, a lot of people, that I am very flirtatious. But, I mean, that's just who I am. I'm a friendly person. But I think my friendliness can come off as, like, me being flirty. Which is, I don't know. I don't know how to stop that because that's just who I am. I don't mean to be flirty, but that's just me. That can get me in a lot of trouble. You know, if you're the same way, because it's weird because when I try to flirt on purpose, it's awkward. So when I don't try to flirt and I just be myself, that's when people think I'm trying to flirt. In reality, like that's backwards. Yeah, you just have to tone it down, you know, for like the last story. You just tone down your whatever you got going on, you know. But yeah, I just want to throw that in there. Throw it in there, pour it in, do a little sip. It was nasty. What?
I worked at a KFC as my third job.
Okay.
And I regret it. I worked with a certain guy. Let's call him John. And he was the creepiest guy I've ever known.
Okay.
This takes place in Maryland.
Oh! Maryland. For anybody that doesn't know. Born and raised in Maryland. Alright. Shouts out to my DMV folks. You know, shouts out to my Maryland folks. Shouts out to my, you know, Northern folks. Where y'all at with y'all? What's good? What's up? Hey, throw y'all set up, yo. Hey, that's what I'm talking about. Maryland represent. If you're from around the DMV area, hashtag DMV. And let me know what you represent. Prince George's County. PG. What's good? Yeah. I mean, I live in Georgia now. But I'm from Maryland, DMV area, so. If you're from around that area, let me know that in the comment section. Throw your setup.
My coworker John one day was telling all of us a crazy story that he was particularly happy about. Mm-hmm. We'd never seen him so energetic or excited. He kept telling us that he had kidnapped someone.
What the fuck?
Of course, we thought he was just joking. On the news at the same time, there had been a kidnapping. And they were looking for the kidnapper, so we thought he was just pulling our leg. I mean, seriously, we thought he was just pranking us. Well, 2 days later, police surround the building. Oh, and I mean 20 different officers storm the building.
Damn.
They pin John to the ground, and he's just smiling and laughing about it. Then he tells all of us, told you so, over and over again. And I'm blatantly horrified that we didn't listen to him. He came right out and told us the horrors he had committed, and we didn't listen. John is now locked up for life, thanks to multiple different charges, most of which were far worse than just kidnapping.
Shit.
John was a vile human being, a wolf in sheep's clothing.
So how the hell did he get the job?
Number 8. KFC Creepy Man, submitted by Baby Love.
Whoever hired him was clocking up.
I was 19 at the time, living with my boyfriend Kane, as well as his friends and their dogs. It was rough, but we were doing our best. At the time I worked at KFC, I had a part-time shift from 12 p.m. to 5 p.m.
Okay.
One day it was just me, my friend Jay, and the manager Bobby at the restaurant. We were talking and trying to make ourselves seem busy, when finally a customer walks into the building. The guy was about 6 feet. He walks in, orders a number 2, and Jay takes his order. I'm by the fryers wiping down things, but when I look over, I notice that the man is looking at me and no one else. And I notice he's not even breaking eye contact. He just keeps staring. Not too long after that, my shift was over. I said goodnight to my coworkers and left for home. When I got back, Kane had dinner ready. We watched some TV until it was time for bed. At around 9 p.m., only a few minutes after going to bed, I was awakened by the dogs growling.
Oh, shit.
I slowly got out of bed, still exhausted, and the dogs followed me downstairs, and that's where my memory comes out. The next thing I do remember is waking up in the hospital with the worst headache I've ever had. Kane is next to my bed, and he tells me everything. He says he saw me get out of bed, and then he heard glass breaking, and all the dogs were snarling, barking, and going crazy. The guys ran downstairs, and they saw a man running out of the house, standing over my body. Turns out it was the same man who had ordered at KFC earlier. He had followed me home, and broke in while we were trying to sleep. He didn't get too far, though, thanks to the dogs, But when he saw me, he quickly knocked me out, leaving me with a pretty bad concussion in the process. The guy was arrested and is now in jail, but I know things could have been much worse if it wasn't for those amazing dogs. They warned me and chased him off after he attacked me. That man is still in prison, and the KFC I used to work at is now some pharmacy. We live at the same place, and I'm happy to not be working customer service anymore. Because apparently sometimes the customers service you.
Okay, I get it.
Number 9. Crazy Lady at KFC. Submitted by Jalen.
Who? It doesn't even say. He got it confused a little bit. That's alright.
I'm 15 years old, and I'm pretty tall for my age. For the past 9 months, my dad has been gone. My mom and dad were together for 16 years, but now that he's gone, I only get to see him every weekend. This situation has happened to me 3 different times. The first time it happened was about a month and a half ago. We were at a KFC drive-thru, and a woman comes up to the passenger front seat, and they're just looking at me while I'm waiting. I start laughing and poke my dad, nod my head over to the window so he'd see the lady there. That's when she knocks on the glass. I'm not gonna lie, I was kind of hesitant to even be that close to her, but I rolled down the window and I gave her the time of day. She was standing right up against the car. She had blonde hair and was wearing really dirty clothes. As I'm rolling down the window, she basically shouts, "Hi, do you have gas money? I could use like $4 or $5.
Back up, lady.
Then proceeds to tell me her life story about how her dad passed away and how...
Okay. I really don't like people like that. I really don't. Like, coming where I'm coming from up north, we like to keep everything short and to the point. You know? Don't, you know, just say it. Just say it. Just be blunt about it. Now, just hurry up. Don't sugarcoat nothing. Don't give me a whole life lesson. Don't tell me about your past or your future. Like, I don't need to know all that. You know, just tell me why you know, what's up. I hate that. Okay, well, I don't hate anything, but I really don't like that. Like, when I moved down in Georgia to Georgia, it took me a while to get adjusted to the people and how people live down here, because, you know, everything is such fast paced up north. So like, but everything is like really slow down here. It's like, and people want to get in your business. It seems like everybody wants to get into your business. That's crazy. Me, I'm just all about my business. That's it. You know, I don't like getting in nobody's business. So, I don't know. I just don't like that. I just don't. Just saying. And people are surprisingly nice. Some of them. Some of them are racist as hell. And rude, but like the people that's like really nice, I had to get adjusted to that too. I'm not it's a whole different world down south than it is up north. And I know vice versa for you all too. I know it's different, you know, if you was born in the south, I know it's different than it is up north.
Life has it out for her and all that. Now I don't really believe her, but I humor her. I open my wallet and hand her $5. Then she walks away, and everything's good.
Okay.
Then about 3 weeks later, I'm at the drive-thru there. My dad and my sister are with us. It's really late at night. It's dark outside, and no one else is around, it seems. They tell us to pull up and wait about 10 more minutes for fresh chicken, as at that time of night, it has to be cooked to order. Someone suddenly comes up to my window and starts tapping on the glass, scaring the bejesus out of me. I couldn't really see who it was more than a silhouette, but they sounded feminine. She said she needed help, so I rolled down my window a little bit. Then she starts talking, saying she doesn't have money and needs to get to the hospital because her dad passed away. I realize it was the same woman as before. I said we didn't have any money to give her, and she said thank you, but sounded very upset about it. Now let's get back to last Thursday. My dad came to pick me up from a school event that I spoke at around 8:30, then took me out to eat. Of course, I picked KFC again, because, as they say, it's finger-licking good.
Not that
This is where I decide to get bold. We're pulling in, waiting to order, and this woman, the same woman from the last two times, came up to the car window again.
Damn.
And asks for the same thing. I was getting fed up. I didn't even realize what I said until I said it. Oh, okay, so you've got three dead dads now. Instantly, her face goes from fake crying to holding so much anger and hatred. She takes two good steps away from my car, pulls out what appears to be some knife, and starts screaming at the top of her lungs at me, and slams herself against my window, slashing at it with the knife, while banging her other fist against it, trying to break it. I'm having a panic attack, and I yell to my dad to just go, go, go. As soon as we drive away from her, she takes off down the street. My dad circles back around and lets the restaurant employees know what's going on. But I'm still freaking out. We were just attacked. If it weren't for the thin glass window in the car, I'd be covered in holes right now. I'd never seen anything like it. This supposed beggar who needs help went from tragic to nightmare fuel in the matter of seconds. Crazy KFC woman, let's never meet again.
Okay.
And number 10, why I don't like KFC. Submitted by Edman.
Okay, so you got three dead dads.
This happened a decade ago when I was around 9. It was a normal day, and I was starving. I was begging my parents from the back seat to get some KFC. It was only 5 blocks away. I must have caught them when they were hungry too, so they were like, why not? We drove over. This particular store was a KFC Taco Bell mix. We sat down at a table. My mom told me to hold her purse. Then they walked over to the counter to place our order. But as they were ordering, a man with a graying beard sat next to me. Innocently enough, he asked me my name and how old I was, and I told him. He introduced himself, though I can't remember what he said his name was. He even said a joke that made me laugh, but again, I can't remember what he said. But he did start asking me other questions after that. Questions that, even at that age, I knew were strange. Like what my phone number was, what my street address was, what kind of stuff I had in my room. All I could really answer was I didn't know if I could be talking to him without my parents knowing. He suddenly got very angry. He reaches out a hand and forces the smile back on his face and asks, "Would you like to come with me?" I said no, I'm waiting on my parents and I'm hungry. He smiled even bigger and said, "It'll be quick, I promise. You'll be back in no time." Being the stupid 9-year-old I was, I followed him.
Damn.
He was taking me outside the building, and I said to him, "Wait, I need to stay inside where my parents can see me." Then, without a word, he just yanked me out of the building, and he put his hand around my mouth so I couldn't scream. He dragged me to what must have been his car. He began to open the back passenger door, and I took the chance to break free from him. I managed to make it back to my dad, who was calling my name and exiting the building. I ran into his arms, crying, and the guy just took off. The police were called, and they managed to catch the guy. He was soon thrown in jail. If I hadn't made it to my dad in time, I know that he would have taken me. And what he was planning to do, wherever he was taking me, I don't know. But it still keeps me up at night. I know for some people, these stories can change your mind about how you feel about certain places. But don't let them keep you from enjoying some fatty chicken. I mean, 20 minutes from now, I might be back at Popeye's ordering those terrible but delicious biscuits. So go on. Go out there and enjoy what you like. Just be careful. Be cautious. Keep your eyes peeled. Because in a world where we take our safety for granted, we are always at a disadvantage to whoever wants to hurt us. It could be an angry worker, ready to go out in a blaze of glory and take the customers with him. Or it could be some customer who takes a fancying to you and decides to wait for you all night in the parking lot or if the door's unlocked in the back seat of your car. Good night. Be sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. And don't forget, send me your scary experiences while using Lyft at darknessprevails.org/submit. If you want to support this channel, think about buying some Darkness Prevails-themed merchandise at morbidmonsters.com. We've got mugs, stickers, decals, and t-shirts. Or, if possible, think about donating $1 a month at patreon.com/darknessprevails to keep us afloat, no matter how volatile YouTube is. As promised, I'm going to read you my favorite early comments from the previous video.
That's him?
I'm sorry if I look exhausted. I don't think I slept at all last night. Claire Strange says, I see you love saying my last name a lot. Well, Claire, as long as you don't trademark that last name, you're going to be just fine. Desm DK says, I almost got hit by a truck earlier. What a nice reminder. Well, Desm, I'm just glad you're here to tell the tale. Now, did you hit the truck back for doing that to you? You have to establish dominance or it's just going to keep happening. Aeon says, when you're early enough to be in the next video, so you comment something kind about the video without even watching it. Now that's extremely loyal of you, but I'd rather you be honest and just smash that like button with all your fake accounts. Thank you. Sportsfan JW says, it's been a while since I've been around this channel. Long time no see. I don't know why I was unsubbed from you. I thought you just disappeared. It's not you, sports fan, it's just YouTube, who seems to be bent on destroying me and hiding all the evidence. But I'll be here, like a tumorous cancer cell. Oh, that whispers sweet, scary stories in your ear.
That was deep as hell.
And sweetheart Sona says, just keep on trucking. Did you just assume my vehicle? Anyway, thank you all so much for listening and sticking around till the end. As always, stay safe out there, and stay creepy. Now, here are the credits to all my patrons who donate and help make this channel less dependent on YouTube.
Oh, I did not know what he looked like. That's my first time ever seeing him. That's crazy. That's a lot of names right there, too. I wonder if that's like his real voice or is it edited? For anybody that's like a real fan of his, let me know in the comment section. Is that his real voice or does he edit that? Because if that's his real voice, dude, you gotta, yo, I mean this in the most nicest of voice. I mean no disrespect. But if that's your real voice, you got a creepy ass voice. Just saying, man. Comment below, let me know what your favorite chicken spot is. You know, whether it's like KFC or, Popeyes. I think it's called Wingstop. If you're from Marco's got some chickens over there. Who else? Domino's, Lido's, Papa John's, Pizza Hut, you know. Just name your favorite chicken spot. You know, this happened to me one time in my life. I think, I don't know where it was either Popeye's or KFC. Something that's, a restaurant that's known to have something. Or, like, it's in the name of their business. But I was at either Popeyes or KFC. And, you know, I was with somebody and we were trying to order some chicken. Mind you, these are places that's known for their chicken. So I'm, you know, we ordered, or we tried to order, and the person, the person that was on the speaker box, whatever, said, "I'm sorry, we don't have any chicken." What? What? Your KFC, your Popeyes, you're known for your chicken. What do you mean? That's like me saying, no. Yeah. That's like you coming to me and you say, "Gator, I need some advice on hauling ass." And I come and I say in return, "I have no advice." What? That makes no sense. If you want some advice on hauling ass, then I got you. I can give you that advice. This is a long ass video. But I told you we were just gonna be chilling tonight. We're just gonna be chilling, we're gonna be vibing, we're gonna be relaxing. And I told you this. I did not expect it to be this long though. But yeah, man. A lot of those stories in this video was enough for me to either switch the job I was at, or like move. Like, that's crazy. Like, yo, that one story with the red eyes, man, I'm quitting right then and there, man. God damn, this pollen. Got that. Oh. But yeah, man. I just wanted to make this video and this reaction because I was, you know, I was bored. And I'm just that type of person to be like, you know, if you call me, if you hit me up on my phone and be like, "Yo, I'm bored." And I say, "I'm bored too." Hey, we can both be bored together. You know, just saying. I got homies like that. I got peoples like that. They'd be like, "Yo, what you doing?" "Nothing." "What you doing?" "Nothing." "Hey, you want to do nothing together? All right, come on over. You want to do nothing together?" You know, I'm just that guy. Hey, keep it cool, keep it classy, and I love you. Stay happy and running. I love you, my fam. Please.